Sandeep, welcome and thank you so much for your contribution to the PitchMe competition over there at the Startup Conference.
It was a lot of fun.
Can you tell me a little bit about how it went there? I'm always interested in entrepreneurs pitching. I put a virtual program together, Pitch Perfect, years ago, trying to support that. And you had some great points. I was wondering if you could share those.
Yeah, I think a lot of them did a really good job. It's very, very difficult to sort of pitch within 60 seconds, as you know.
Okay.
But I think a lot of them did a really good job. I think where some of them kind of stumbled a little bit is because you only get 60 seconds, you should lead with the strongest suit. So in a lot of cases, they had a lot of good traction, but they never talked about it until we actually prodded them to.
Right.
Or they had a really good team, or they had a great product. So, you know, you do not lead with your strongest suit, and they were describing the problem, you know, which is what you normally do if you have like 20, 30 minutes.
Yeah.
You know, you start with the problem, and then you talk about the solution, and then you talk about the rest of the traction that you have. But when you do a 60-second pitch, you have to almost invert it and like grab people, you know, with the very first or second sentence that you do. So that's where I think a few people, you know, kind of made a mistake. But
fabulous advice, and because everyone needs to do that elevator pitch, right? And do it well, right?
Yeah. Absolutely.
Yeah. So you come from Felicis Ventures, and I know Aidan, and I know that you guys have been incredible as far as investing in women, and I know there's a lot of female founders that watch my vlog. I was wondering if you could tell me just briefly how many startups you've got with female founders and your perspective on that.
Yeah, you know, it's something which we almost never counted until recently, and I think it showed up as two dozen, you know, last we counted.
Wow.
We're also, you know, with the six on our team, on the Felicis team, it's ourselves, three on the investment side and three on the operation side, and we're 60% female, which is also unusual, you know, for an investment firm.
Yes.
We're also 100% immigrant. You know, it's a very unique sort of internal culture that we have. You know, we have, you know, Aidan's Turkish, Renata is Brazilian, I'm Indian, Dasha is Russian, Sadie is Scottish, and we just added Gurgana as the CFO, who's Bulgarian. So it's like, it almost looks like United Nations, you know, back at our office.
And I know that you guys invest all over the world, and I heard, what is your mission about that? Like, you're obviously not worried about whether startups are actually based here in the Valley, but you're looking at the best startups, am I right?
Yeah, I think increasingly we're going to find a lot of that, is that a lot of, you know, amazing companies are coming out from all parts of the world. And there's a couple of main reasons for that. One is, as you can see even today, a lot of the folks even who pitched today built so many amazing products on just like a couple, you know, people and like $10,000, right? And increasingly that kind of money and, you know, that amount of talent is available in all parts of the world. So you can create, you know, an Angry Birds out of Finland, you can create an Atlassian out of Australia and stuff like that. So you're going to see more amazing companies come out, and, you know, we naturally have, like, you know, networks abroad. We have, like, you know, companies, you know, approaching us from abroad. And so we looked at that and said, you know, why should we not invest in different parts of the world? And for us, the more important thing is, you know, focusing on our themes. You know, we invest in five different areas, and we're much more geo-agnostic and stage-agnostic when we come to our investing.
Well, I'm totally supportive of that. Yeah. Because I was locked out when I had a business in Ireland and also in London for about 11 years. So really, I want to see a small world. I want to now, with virtual reality, why not?
Why,
you know,
not?
And
I'll tell you, you know, my previous startup was in Chicago, and even Chicago was a bridge too far, because a lot of folks are like, oh, this is a good company, but I don't really know whether I want to come to Chicago for a board meeting. And
yeah.
I'm like, what has that got to do with anything?
So you're groundbreaking, really, that you're extending your borders and boundaries out to the rest of the globe. It's fabulous. And I know that you invest in the Middle East, and obviously Nima, my business partner, is very focused on that with progress in technology in the Middle East with PitMe. So I just wondered if you could talk a little bit about that market.
Yeah, I think it's an emerging market. I think we're going to see really interesting companies come out of there. Again, you know, there's a lot of, you know, consumers over there, a lot of folks who basically have the money to spend, but not enough, you know, technology entrepreneurs focusing on the market. So I think we're going to start seeing interesting companies come out of there. And Aydin's Turkish, so he keeps a close, you know, ear to the ground when it comes to that stuff. We were investors in one of the companies called Yamly, which is a translation, Arabic translation company. So Habib, you know, is a founder. He's moved back now to Egypt, and he's starting his own fund over there, you know, investing in the local companies. So I think we're going to starting to see like more activity and more interesting things come out.
Well, thank you so much for supporting that ecosystem, because I know it's underserved, and obviously that's why Nima is trying to bring more attention and focus and support to them. So thanks again for your time today. It's been a total pleasure meeting you, and I hope we get to talk some more.
Absolutely.
Thank you.
You.